See, we were to discuss group 15. Let's see what all things we must know about group 15. Group 15, first, what are the general characteristics? That includes the nature of the elements here. You can see nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, and bismuth. These are the elements. Nitrogen, phosphorus are non-metals. They are non-metals in nature. And antimony and this are metalloids, while bismuth is metallic in nature. Okay. Atomic size wise, if you look at it, nitrogen is smaller than phosphorus, then arsenic, then antimony, then bismuth. So the size is nominally decreasing the way it is to be, except that you would see bismuth and antimony has very close radius, so which is around 141 picometers, while this is 148 picometers. Okay. So the difference in the atomic size is very small compared to when you compare antimony and bismuth. Volume and density, both of these factors will normally increase down the group. Got it? Well, if you see the ionization of this, generally you will feel that 15th group elements will have more first ionization compared to 16th group, compared to 14th group. Okay. As an example, if you recall, nitrogen had more first ionization compared to oxygen and compared to carbon. This is what has been identified for ionization. If you see ionization enthalpies for first, second, and third, how they vary, obviously down the group they usually decrease. Down the group they usually decrease. So nitrogen is more than phosphorus, then arsenic, antimony, and bismuth. So there is a regular increase, regular decrease in the ionization here. While if it comes to second and third ionization, there is a slight difference in terms of bismuth and antimony. Okay. And no reason for this, because their atomic radiuses are very close. That's why there is slightly more there is more ionization observed for bismuth as compared to that of antimony. Okay. Clear, everybody? So you can see, in any case, delta H1 will always be less than delta H2 is less than delta H3. That I'm sure you all know that. Okay. This is about ionization, how it varies down the group. Now see electron affinity. So you got to know that electron affinity will always, in general, it will always decrease down the group. Okay, it is usually decreasing down the group. Now, what happens in this group is that they have a stable configuration of NH2 and NP3, so which is a half-filled stable configuration. Okay, so delta H of but in this case, for nitrogen, it is a positive value. So for nitrogen, it is positive value because nitrogen do not accept the electrons that easily, yeah, because of its stable configuration. Okay. And what are the other elements which behave similar to nitrogen? If you just recall, the other elements which does the same thing, I'll put it all the list, that nitrogen, beryllium, magnesium, as well as
just now, have I missed anything?
Chaitanya just started, beta. Group 15. In group 15, I just started with the general characteristics, which includes its nature, atomic size, volume, and density.
So could you go over it once again in a quick fashion? Minus, I had forgotten that we had a lecture today. I'm so sorry.
No, sure. Listen, see, when it comes to group 15, these are the elements, nitrogen to bismuth. Nitrogen and phosphorus are generally non-metals. Antimony and arsenic are metalloids. Bismuth is metallic in nature. Okay. Atomic size, it is a regular trend of, increasing atomic size. Like from nitrogen to phosphorus, it goes this way, to arsenic, to antimony. But when it comes to bismuth, the antimony and bismuth are almost of same size. That is 141 picometers and 148 picometers. Okay. Now, if you compare volume and density, down the group, volume and density always increases. Okay. And if you see ionization enthalpies, generally we know that nitrogen, you know, will have more ionization than oxygen, than carbon. Correct? Why? Because it has a stable configuration of 2s2 and 2p3, half filled stability attained in 2p3. So it is reluctant to accept, it is reluctant to give away electron that easily. Clear? The same logic follows for all of the rest of the group elements. That is, 15th group elements will be greater than 16th, then greater than 14th. Generally, what you'll observe that in delta, the first ionization, nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, bismuth, it is decreasing down the group, you know, which is a regular trend. But delta H2 and delta H3, on the other hand, bismuth will have slightly more amount of ionization compared to antimony. This comes with the fact that the Z effective is much higher for bismuth because of its smaller size. Okay. So there is always, you know, a small difference between antimony and bismuth. So it's better to remember it. The first one is a regular trend. The next two are bismuth slightly greater than that of antimony. In any case, the first ionization of any element will always be less than the second ionization compared to that of third ionization energy. Right, beta? Now we are discussing about electron affinity. Electron affinity, here if you look at it, NS2, NP3 being a general configuration of this group. Nitrogen is highly reluctant to accept the electron also because of its already existing half-filled stability. Some more elements which are of a similar category are nitrogen, beryllium, magnesium, and all inert gases. They also are reluctant to release any electrons or accept any electrons, correct? So electron affinity is about accepting electrons, so none of them will accept. Apart of these elements, all other elements have negative delta HEGE, that is electron gain enthalpy. Okay. So if it has negative electron gain enthalpy, then what happens to the electron affinity? We know that electron affinity is just the opposite of electron gain enthalpy in terms of sign, correct? So if delta H electron gain enthalpy, correct, is more negative, which means electron affinity will be positive. While electron gain enthalpy is positive, that's why nitrogen is negative. So minus 8, then 72, 78, 103, and 105. This is the only group where electron gain enthalpy is actually increasing down the group, you know, as a regular trend. Normally in all other groups, electron gain enthalpy should decrease down the group. So here it is increasing down the group all the way up to bismuth. Have you understood this logic, everybody?
Yes.
Right. Idea that is electronegativity. Right. Electronegativity values, if you look at it, nitrogen has 3.0, phosphorus has 2.1. Is there any lag? Can you all see this? What I'm writing?
There's slight bit of delay.
Okay. 2.0 is arsenic, 1.9 and 1.9 is bismuth. So you can see arsenic, antimony, bismuth has almost same electronegativity. Okay. So they have almost a similar characteristic in terms of, you know, accepting electrons. Now, when it comes to...
Sir, I put a doubt here.
Tanish, bolo bolo.
सर इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एंथैल्पी और इलेक्ट्रॉन अफिनिटी इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी के ट्रेंड में मतलब ऐसा उल्टा क्यों चल रहा है?
देखो, इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एंथैल्पी में हम लोग इलेक्ट्रॉन को कंप्लीटली लूज कर रहे हैं, ठीक है? तो डाउन द ग्रुप क्या हो रहा है आप देखोगे तो नाइट्रोजन इट हैज अ स्टेबल कॉन्फिगरेशन ऑफ NP3, है ना? अब आप जैसे जैसे डाउन जाओगे ना बेटा, देखो 2s, 2p और 3s, इनमें एनर्जी डिफरेंस काफी रहता है. बट इफ यू गो टूवर्ड्स बिस्मत, राइट, बिस्मत में क्या रहेगा? 6s, 6p. बराबर करेक्ट। इनके अलावा 4f ऑर्बिटॉल है, 5d ऑर्बिटॉल है, 6p ऑर्बिटॉल है, इसके बाद 6d ऑर्बिटॉल भी है, इनफैक्ट 5f भी है ना। इन सब में एनर्जी डिफरेंस बहुत ही कम होता है, ठीक है। सो द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ हाफ फिल नेचर इन इन पी ऑर्बिटॉल इज नॉट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर हियर, कि ये इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इजिली यहां पर भी माइग्रेट कर सकते हैं, करेक्ट। सो इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू गेट यू नो वेरी स्टेबल नेचर जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ द हाफ फील्ड स्टेबिलिटी इन पी ऑर्बिटॉल, क्लियर बेटा?
ओके,
विच इज अदरवाइज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर फॉर नाइट्रोजन।
ओके,
नाउ कमिंग टू द मेल्टिंग पॉइंट, व्हेन इट कम्स टू मेल्टिंग पॉइंट हियर, मेल्टिंग पॉइंट में हमेशा डिपेंड कर रहे, मेल्टिंग पॉइंट में हमेशा ये है, अगर मेटल है तो उसके नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स कितने पार्टिसिपेट कर रहे हैं इन मेटालिक बॉन्ड्स। नाउ
वी ऑलवेज, सर आपकी आवाज भी बीच-बीच में कट रही है,
इज इट ब्रेकिंग गाइस?
इज इट जस्ट फॉर मी या फिर हो रहा था?
आई डोंट नो, इज माय वॉइस ब्रेकिंग बेटा? एनीबॉडी प्लीज कम
सर, बराबर लग
चेतन, कैन यू प्लीज चेक
इट? हां सर, बराबर।
ओके सर, यस।
या सी, इफ वी टॉक अबाउट मेल्टिंग पॉइंट, एज आई सेड, मेल्टिंग पॉइंट में अगर मेटल की बात हो रही है तो हमेशा ये देखना है कि क्या वो मेटल बहुत सारे इलेक्ट्रॉन्स पार्टिसिपेट कर रहा है मेटालिक बॉन्ड में या नहीं कर रहा है। देखो, डाउन द ग्रुप हमको पता है कि इनर्ट पेयर इफेक्ट विल ऑलवेज बी मोर इन्फ्लुएंसिंग, विच मीन्स NS2, NP3, इफ यू ऑब्जर्व, NS2 के इलेक्ट्रॉन्स ज्यादा पार्टिसिपेट नहीं करते, करेक्ट। विच मीन्स इफ यू कंपेयर ऑल ऑफ दिस, बिस्मत में सबसे कम इलेक्ट्रॉन पार्टिसिपेशन होगा, हेंस डाउन द ग्रुप, क्योंकि मेटालिक कैरेक्टर इंक्रीज हो रहा है तो ऑब्वियसली इंक्रीज होना चाहिए मेल्टिंग पॉइंट, बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली बिस्मत का मेल्टिंग पॉइंट कम क्यों है? बिकॉज इट इज नॉट पार्टिसिपेटिंग इट्स NS इलेक्ट्रॉन्स। आई कैन से द NS इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, NS2 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर नॉट पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन मेटालिक बॉन्ड, पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन मेटालिक बॉन्ड, हेंस the melting point is not higher for bismuth, rather it is more for antimony. आपको ये वाला point अच्छे से याद रखना है, that antimony has the highest melting point. So ये directly question आ सकता है, आपको इतना ही पूछेगा कि which has the highest. Order usually नहीं पूछा गया अभी तक, but please learn it that इसका melting point ज्यादा होता है. Next, boiling point. If you observe the boiling point, nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, then bismuth, and then antimony. Now, when it comes to boiling point, beta, two things are both influence karti hai, correct? One is how much is the atomic weight. Along with that, you will have how much is the participation of electrons, correct? So, if you see, इलेक्ट्रॉन पार्टिसिपेशन ऑफ बिस्मत इज लेस बिकॉज ऑफ हाई जेड इफेक्टिव ज्यादा है बिस्मत में, सो वो कोवेलेंट बॉन्डिंग या वैंडरवॉल फोर्सेस ये ज्यादा क्रिएट नहीं कर सकता है, वाइल एंटीमोनी कैन डू बेटर एंड ऑल्सो पोजेस मोर मोलार मास, मोर एटोमिक मास, करेक्ट, नॉट विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू बिस्मत कंपेयर टू अदर्स। सो इफ यू सी, antimony has more like a win-win situation, so therefore it will be slightly better than, you know, bismuth. So this is the order of boiling point, right, in group 15. Have you all understood what I said? Okay. Now let's see about bond energy. Normally bond energy, single bonds ka energy as you go down wo kam hona chahiye, बॉन्ड लेंथ बढ़ जाता है, सो इट इज इजी टू ब्रेक द बॉन्ड, बट when it comes to PP single, you will see nitrogen pair and nitrogen lone pair. There is a lone pair repulsion between these two. And because of the lone pair repulsion between these two, right? Danish?
Sir, aapka voice crack ho raha hai shayad. Sabke liye ho raha hai kya?
Crack ho raha hai kya? Ek minute. Let me check.
सर बराबर लग रहा है
तनिष्क लेट मी रिपीट अगेन लिसन व्हाट आई सेड इज इफ यू कंपेयर पीपी बॉन्ड एंड एनएन देन वी कैन से एनएन बॉन्ड जो है ना इसमें लोन पे रिपल्शन ज्यादा रहेंगे बिकॉज ऑफ द लोन पे रिपल्शन हियर. Although the bond length is smaller, it is easy to break this bond as compared to phosphorus and phosphorus in a single bond as compared to arsenic, as compared to antimony. Bismuth is a metal, so it does not make any single bonds like this. Clear, everybody? Next.
Yes.
Next, see the nature of bonding. Nitrogen can also form very easy pi-pi bonds, okay? Because इसका ओवरलैपिंग 2p पाई और 2p पाई का ओवरलैपिंग है सो विच इज मच इजियर फॉर नाइट्रोजन सो इट कैन फॉर्म विद इटसेल्फ एंड ऑल्सो इट कैन फॉर्म विद नाइट्रोजन ऑक्सीजन बोरॉन एंड सो ऑन सो ऑक्सीजन के साथ भी फॉर्म कर सकता है आपस में डबल बॉन्ड ट्रिपल बॉन्ड बना सकता है कार्बन के साथ डबल बॉन्ड ट्रिपल बॉन्ड बना सकता है ओके व्हाइल व्हेन इट कम्स टू फॉस्फोरस बिकॉज ऑफ द लार्ज साइज एंड पुअर ओवरलैपिंग Phosphorus and others do not form p-pi-p-pi bonds, but they form d-pi-p-pi bonds. Like phosphorus or oxygen ke saath double bond O ban sakta hai. Phosphorus or carbon ke saath double bond C ban sakta hai. But P or P ke beech mein double bond usually nahi banega. Phosphorus and arsenic can form d-pi-d-pi bonds also with transition metals. Okay? Ye thode se d-pi-d-pi bond banate hai, but not very prominently observed. So between metal okay and phosphorus here you will see kaise banata hai ye if you recall agar in dono ke beech mein is tarah se sigma bond bana hai phosphorus has given its lone pair correct then whatever the electrons present in the p metal here they will start sharing with the pi star d pi star orbital ye jo pi star orbital aa raha hai wo d pi star ka hai correct Sorry, ये pi star नहीं है, minus star. This is only d, so this is d, d pi orbital, and this is also d pi orbital. So d pi और d pi के बीच में bonding हो रहा है, and we have learned this in complexes, and that is one of the reasons why PR3 is also a very strong ligand. Okay, the same logic applies for arsenic also. So in transition metals, we will see this d pi overlapping happening. Clear everybody. Next, nitrogen can't form this d pi p pi bonds due to the absence of d orbitals. Okay. Next, if you see the property of catenation power of these elements is very less as compared to group 14. Okay, due to the less bond dissociation energy which it can make. Why that happens? If you see the catenating power, how it changes, right? The single bond we just learned that phosphorus ka better hai so therefore p and p makes better catenation as compared to n and n bonds okay as compared to as and as bonds as compared to antimony and antimony bonds as come that's it okay this is how it would be formed got it so phosphorus or phosphorus ka catenation ban sakta hai taking all the single bonds okay nitrogen very rare Arsenic, antimony also very rare. So phosphorus is the one which we'll usually see. Haan, arsenic or antimony mein aap AS4, SB4 banta hai. Okay. Next. You see, nitrogen has very less tendency to form single bonds with NN bonds because it can form more stronger multiple bonds within itself. Which means, instead of making single bonds within the molecule, it will try to make multiple bonds like N, triple bond N or N double bond N, and this way. These type of bonds are more prominent for nitrogen. Although there is a lone pair repulsions, ye bond energy itna zyada strong hai ki it will overcome that lone pair repulsions also. While phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, they all form tetraatomic species. So they will form tetraatomic species. Okay. Next. If you see the oxidation states, the common oxidation states which are coming for nitrogen, right? I mean, generally for this group is -3, +3, and 5. And if you see it for nitrogen, what are all the oxidation state which can exist? Nitrogen in NH3 has -3. Here we have -2, -1, -1/3 also, +1, +2, +3, +4. Okay. And if I take N2O5, it has +5. So the oxidation state of nitrogen, you know, ranges from -3/+5. Okay. While if you look at the phosphorus changes from -3, -2, +1, +3, +4, +5. Okay. Phosphorus, this is the only compound H4P2O6. This is the only compound where phosphorus shows +4. Otherwise, phosphorus ke +4 identify nahi kiye jaate hai. So it is showing anything from -3 to +5. Okay. Now, in JE once it has been asked, how is the structure of hydrozoic acid? Discuss the hybridization, discuss this shape, how it looks like. Hydrozoic acid N3H looks this way. We have H, N, double bond N with positive and negative. Okay. It can also be written in terms of resonating form as N with N, triple bond N with positive, sorry, double bond N here. So if you write this, this is not triple bond. This is double bond only. So we have here with nitrogen, double bond N, and this being triple bond. So ye single bond aa jayega idhar. So this would have minus charge on it like this. So if you see these two cases here, these are all resonating forms of hydrozoic acid. Now, if you see the hybridization on all of this, you know, here nitrogen, you know, is sp2 hybridized, while here nitrogen is sp hybridized, here also it is sp hybridized. Correct. So between these three nitrogens, if you compare up to this part, it is linear. Up to this part it is linear. Agar aapko n3 minus diya hai, so we can always say it is completely linear. Okay. It's completely linear species and hybridization will become sp in all the cases. So I hope you guys understood that. Next, if you see the stability of -3 na beta, as you go down the group, okay, -3 ka ability kam ho jayega because metallic character is increasing. And if you see +5 character, oxidation state jaise matlab as you go down towards the bismuth, +5 bhi kam ho jaye because of inert pair effect. The only thing that increases is +3 oxidation state. So +3 oxidation state will always increase down the group. So bismuth usually show +5 and +3 also, but +5 is usually unstable. Okay. Hence bismuth +5 acts as, you know, bismuth +5 acts as oxidizing agent, which means it will try to become +3 very easily. Okay. And it shows this +5 oxidation state only with highly electronegative elements like oxygen and fluorine. Leo. Now, this is an important statement. The next line is an important statement. If the oxidation state is between +1 to +4, if it is between +1 to +4, correct? For nitrogen, then it undergoes disproportionation. Then it undergoes disproportionation. So plus 1 से लेकर plus 4 के बीच में, plus 2, plus 3, even plus 4 if it is there, including this, okay? If you have any of this oxidation state, it will undergo disproportionation, okay? Let me add you with an example. HNO2, the oxidation state is plus 3, correct? Oxidation state is plus 3. It will convert into HNO3 plus NO. So nitrous acid unstable hota hai. Wo, usko, if you keep it for long standing, it will become nitric acid and NO gas is released. Got it? Clear everybody? Very important line. So remember, plus 1 se lekar plus 4 ke beech mein jitne bhi oxidation states hota hai, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4. Well, plus 1 or plus 1 bhi hota hai, but very rarely you will observe in the cases. But mainly remember plus 2, plus 3, you know, cases. It will undergo disproportionation. Whereas, if you compare phosphorus, phosphorus disproportionation takes both in alkaline and acidic medium to give the products with plus 5 and minus 3 oxidation state only. Which means, eventually, ye disproportionation hote, finally, where does it reach? It will always reach to plus 5 and minus 3. For example, if I take HPO3, correct? 2 minus. HPO3 2 minus, which is phosphorus acid. Phosphorus acid ka base hai. If I add it to H plus in acidic medium, correct? First it will become H3PO3, correct? And in the same acidic medium, if you keep it for long standing, it will become H3PO4 plus PH3. So the oxidation state here will become minus 3, and here you can see it is becoming plus 5. That is what I meant. So it will give plus 5 and minus 3 as the oxidation states. Got it? Next. The plus 3 oxidation state, correct, of bismuth, antimony, arsenic are stable with respect to disproportionation. So they don't disproportionate as much as that of phosphorus does. So I hope all of you got an idea there. Ye dono statements acche se yaad kar lena. How nitrogen behaves between these two and how phosphorus in any other oxidation state will become plus 5 to minus 3 only. Okay. Next. देखो और एक example बताता हूँ जिससे हम लोग शायद वो आप थोड़ा confused हो जाओगे इसके लिए मैं वो अभी बता देता हूँ. Suppose if you have H3PO2, correct, in the presence of OH minus, it will disproportionate to if I had to use this as if I had to use this, let me write down that. Yeah. P4 in basic medium, OH minus, will give us H2PO2, correct, minus plus PH3. अभी यहां पे देखोगे कि oxidation state plus 1 and minus 3 है, which means this is going to go for further disproportionation. ये आगे फिर से disproportionation होगा, but अगर exam में दिया है, P4 कैसे होगा? Because P4 is zero oxidation state. So this will disproportionate first up to plus 1 and minus 3. And this plus 1, if you keep it in acidic medium, leave it for long standing, first it will become plus 3 and minus 3. And the plus 3 again becomes plus 5 and minus 3. Clear everybody? So that's how it will keep disproportionating. Okay. Now, coming to this, hydrides. Hydrides, you know, they exist mainly as EH3. EH5 exist nahi karte hai because EH5 is in highly unstable form. Usually a hybrid is hi nahi hote hai, that's why. So only in the case of nitrogen, hydrides get easily hybridized. So if you see NH3, N2H4, hydrazine, okay, N2H4, N3H, hydrozoic acid, These are various hydrides which are forming. The first two hydrides are basic in nature. This hydride is acidic in nature when it comes to nitrogen. In case of phosphorus, PH3, P2H4, these two are formed. Okay. Now, if you compare these two, PH3 and P2H4, unke property kaise? Abhi thodi der mein padhte. Now see, between nitrogen and phosphorus, these are the hydrides. But other than that, all others will form only EH3 type of hydrides. Now, if you look at the formation of all of this, ammonia ka formation, let me show that. Ammonia is negative formation, while all other PH3, ASH3, SBH3, their delta H formation is positive. Got it? They're all delta H formation is positive. Clear everybody? Now what, why this is happening, students, is yahan par form hone par unko zyada overlapping nahi mil raha hai. Aisa kyun ho raha hai? Dekho, nitrogen mein kya hota hai? If you take N2 plus 3H2, it will become 2NH3. Here nitrogen and hydrogen are nicely overlapping because it is undergoing hybridization and it is forming sp3 hybridized orbital. But if we take phosphorus, P4 react with H2 and you are expecting this to form PH3, correct? Here this phosphorus is not hybridized. This is not sp3 hybridized. It is in fact not hybridized at all. Phosphorus will have simply overlapping from the p orbitals only. Now let's say these are the p orbitals and hydrogen will overlap this way. So there is a very weak overlapping of phosphorus and hydrogen here. Hence the bond dissociation energy is weaker. Clear everybody? So the one which has better overlapping will have better bond dissociation energy. So better, I mean more negative and delta H formation. Okay. Just a minute. Take this call. So sorry, guys. That was my brother after a very long time. Okay. Yeah. Right. Get this. Bond dissociation energy. Like I said, bond dissociation is better for better overlapping. So NH3 is better than PH3. Please remember, all of these are not hybridized. Not hybridized. Okay. And this fact is called as Drago's rule. If you may remember, discuss this before in chemical bonding. Right. Next, reducing nature. If you talk about reducing nature, as you go down the groups, because the bond dissociation energy is weaker, it is easy to give nascent hydrogens in the solution. So hence, reducing nature is better for BiH3. Thermal stability, again, bond strength is better for ammonia. So thermal stability vary this way. Okay. Boiling point is very important factor that has been asked very frequently in exams. So here, learn it. First, BiH3 because of the molar mass. Okay. Then SbH3 again for molar mass. But then comes NH3 because it has hydrogen bonding. After that, AsH3 and finally PH3. Correct? So remember that ammonia comes here. Okay, ammonia comes here. So I hope all of you got that. Next, bond angle. NH3 is greater because it is hybridized. It is sp3 hybridized, so it is around 107 degrees, and all of these are unhybridized, and this can be explained by Drago's rule. All right, so this is around 91 degrees. Okay, this is around 90.7 degrees, 90.5 degrees, and 90.3 degrees, something like this you will have. So this is how the bond angle will vary. Here. Next, basic character, basic nature. Ammonia has the more ability to donate electrons because it has smaller size, it has more concentrated electrons, and the electron is in sp3 hybridized, so it is highly directional. So here this electron is present in okay, sp3 hybridized, hence more directional. So it's more directional, so easy to, you know, keep that electron form there. So if that is clear, right? And you can see, as the central atom size increases, the lone pair electron density decreases. So if you go down the group here, size is increasing here, so the ability to donate electrons will decrease. And pH.
Sure.
Yes, beta.
सर, रिड्यूसिंग नेचर और बेसिक नेचर में फिर कैसे फर्क हुआ सर? मतलब रिड्यूसिंग में भी तो इलेक्ट्रॉन डोनेट करने के
लिए ऐसा सोचो, बात है रिड्यूसिंग नेचर का मतलब क्या है कि आपने कोई ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट के साथ रिएक्ट किया. ओके, करेक्ट. सपोज आपने कोई ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट के साथ रिएक्ट किया, लाइक BiH3, और मे बी एक ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट लाइक O3 के साथ रिएक्ट किया आपने, करेक्ट. तो ये बिस्मत ऑक्सीडाइज हो जाएगा खुद B2O5 में, और ये ऑक्सीजन रिड्यूस हो जाएगा H2O में. समझ में आया? सो ये काफी इजिली हो जाएगा क्योंकि हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड काफी इजिली तोड़कर ऑक्सीजन के साथ वो बॉन्ड कर सकता है.
ओके,
क्लियर बेटा?
Yes, sir.
Next, if you see this PH3 and all, they do not form salt with aqueous acids because, you know, basic character is saras, na beta? Ammonia is more basic, then water, then PH3. So water is more basic than PH3. So hence PH3 does not act like base. So therefore, if you take like PH3 को अगर आपने aqueous HCl में add किया, ठीक है, तो PH3 will remain PH3, correct? Because if you think that वो H3O plus form करेगा, I mean इफ यू थिंक लाइक H3O प्लस एंड Cl माइनस, तो ये HCl और वाटर के बीच में रिएक्शन हो रहा है, HCl और PH3 के बीच में रिएक्शन नहीं हो रहा है. ओके, सो रिमेंबर हियर इट इज H2O रिएक्टिंग विद HCl एंड बिकमिंग H3O प्लस प्लस Cl माइनस. व्हाई इज दैट हैपनिंग? बिकॉज वाटर इज मोर बेसिक देन PH3. क्लियर बेटा? दैट्स व्हाई इट इज हैपनिंग. बट अगर आपको PH3 के साथ रिएक्ट कराना है, सो देन दैट इज नॉट द राइट वे. तो व्हाट यू कैन डू, दिस PH3 आई कैन, इफ एट ऑल आई एड इट टू एक्वस HCl, देन देर इज नो रिएक्शन. बट इफ एट ऑल आई यूज HI एंड एनहाइड्रस, लेट्स से अगर एनहाइड्रस के साथ रिएक्ट करता हूं, देन द रिएक्शन विल टेक प्लेस बिकॉज नाउ देर इज नो वॉटर इन इट, सो इट विल एक्ट लाइक अ बेस नाउ. क्लियर एवरीबडी? एनी डाउट हियर? राइट. नेक्स्ट सी ऑक्साइड्स. देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ ऑक्साइड्स विच एग्जिस्ट हियर. वन इज E2O3 काइंड. E2O3 काइंड, E2O3 मतलब यू विल सी N2O3. ओके, देन वी विल सी P2O3. And P2O3 is same as writing it as P4O6. And similarly, AS2O3, which is same as writing as AS4O6, because they always exist in this dimeric form. And same is the case with, antimony, SB4O6. Okay. But bismuth only exists in this form, Ba2O3. Okay. Now, if you observe, the first two have acidic character. These two have acidic character. Arsenic and antimony both will have amphoteric character, and finally bismuth will be basic. Okay, and if you take E2O5, right, we will have N2O5, and here I will write it as P4O10. So I hope you understand why I'm writing that. AS4O10, SB4O10, again bismuth will only show Bi2O5. Okay, now all of this will start showing acidic character. All of these are acidic character except Bi2O5, which is amphoteric. So we'll have amphoteric oxide character. So I hope this is clear, everybody. These are oxides, how they are formed. Now, coming to this halide forms, how they exist. EX3. They exist as EX3. In EX3, nitrogen forms NF3, NCl3, NBr3 and Ni3. But because of the larger size of them, chlorine, bromine and iodine, and they're very close to each other, they would be explosive. They will be explosive. In fact, they would give more of a redox reaction. It would give more of a redox reaction when you treat this, like N2 plus X2, if you treat both of them, if it forms NX3, the minute it becomes NX3, it will be highly exothermic. This is how it will form. Clear, everybody? Now, coming to phosphorus, it will form PF3, Cl3, Br3, and Pi3, and all of them are stable in this case. And same is the case with arsenic, antimony, bismuth, all of them are stable. Now, the only compound which is ionic is BiF3. Here this is ionic. Okay. Rest all are covalent in the table which I mentioned. I hope this is clear, everybody. I hope you understand why it is ionic also, because fluorine's polarizability is very less, and bismuth can exhibit +3 oxidation state, +3 ionic form, while others cannot exhibit +3 ionic form. They can show oxidation state, but they cannot show complete ionic form because of their very high ionizations. Okay. Clear? Now coming to EX5. If you look at EX5 here, nitrogen does not have any empty d orbital. Ansh, yes, beta.
Sorry, sir, by mistake it happened.
Okay. Phosphorus, on the other hand, can give PF5, PCl5, PBr5, and PI5 does not exist, again because of repulsions, iodine repulsions. AsFi is formed, AsCl3 is formed, but it is very less stable. antimony will form, bismuth only forms with fluoride. Okay. This formation का list आपको समझना है उतना ही, इसमें कोई cases नहीं है या कोई reactions नहीं पूछा है या नहीं NCERT में, वो सब नहीं दिया. If we take P alpha is forming by any means, it will immediately decompose into P I3 plus I2. Okay. This is what is going to form. Next. See the basic character here. Nitrogen, if you see NF3, NCl3, NBr3 and so on, in sab mein agar compare karna hai humko, okay? See, fluorine is withdrawing electrons by inductive effect. So, ability to transfer this lone pair becomes difficult. Therefore, the basic character of Ni3 is better than NF3. While if you talk about any particular halide, let's say NF3 compare with PF3, ASF3, SBF3 and so on. Here, electron density is better for NX3. That's why it would have better basic character. Leo?
Sir, electron density ka kya reason?
क्या डाउन द ग्रुप क्या हो रहा है बेटा, साइज बढ़ रहा है ना सेंट्रल एटम का, तो उसके ऊपर एक इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर है ना, एक कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड पेयर की तरह नहीं दिखेगा यार, मतलब इलेक्ट्रॉन डेंसिटी उसका कम हो जाएगा. ठीक है.
यस यस.
लाइक NBr3 Ni3 को अगर आपको स्टेबलाइज करना है, सो NBr3 will always ammoniates, मतलब आपको अमोनिया में स्टोर करना होगा, where it just like hydration, ये ammoniation हो जाता है. Same Ni3 undergoes ammoniation with ammonia molecules this way. So they exist only as ammoniates. Okay. Now coming to the hydrolysis, NF3, if you see it in normal conditions, water के साथ react नहीं करेगा. Right? Why? It has no d orbital. Na fluorine ke paas d orbital hai, na nitrogen ke paas d orbital hai. So dono hi end se wo attack nahi kar sakta. Okay. Now, if you come across NCl3, in NCl3, this does not have d orbital, no d orbital. But this has d orbital, na? So this chlorine has d orbital. So ye jab water mein add karenge, correct? So water will attack more on the chlorine rather than attacking on nitrogen. So we can say H2O molecule as a lone pair will attack on the empty d orbital of chlorine. So empty d orbital pe attack karega to nitrogen apna electron wapas le lega, so n minus ho jayega, that n minus will again take away H plus from water and that's how it will become ammonia, and OH chlorine ke sath jud jayega, so 3 moles of HOCl will be formed. I hope this is clear, everybody. Next. Yes. If we talk about PF3, PF3 hydrolyzes very slowly because the bonding is very strong between phosphorus and fluorine. So it will go very slowly. While if you talk about PCl3, PCl3 hydrolysis will take place. Yahan par kya ho raha hai? Empty d orbital hai. So we can expect that water would attack on the empty d orbital of phosphorus and slowly remove out chlorine. So one one karke chlorine release ho jayega and you will see 3 moles of HCl forming here. Okay. Clear, everybody? Right. Here, let me write down this also. The slow step. Slow step here is breaking of P and X bond. That is a rate determining step. Okay. See, when it becomes H3PO3, ye hai na, apne aap se tautomerize ho jayega and it will become 1-2 kind of a shift. 1-2 kind of a shift. Matlab ye hydrogen, यहां का हाइड्रोजन इधर शिफ्ट हो जाएगा फास्फोरस के पास. ओके, सो इट विल टॉटोमराइज इन दैट फॉर्म एंड इट विल बिकम पी डबल बॉन्ड ओ ओ एच एंड एच एंड ओ एच. दिस इज हाउ इट विल हैपन एंड दैट इज हाउ द फास्फोरस एसिड इज फॉर्म्ड. okay. यहां पे ऐसा क्यों हो रहा है? देखो, P double bond O is a very strong bond that helps it to undergo tautomerization, and this form, this is like a keto form, na? The keto form is much more stable than like an enol form here. Okay, this is like an enol form. Hence, it will exist in this form. Next, see the basic character. If we compare the basic character here, it will only depend on inductive effect. So PI3 is more basic than PBr3, PCA3 and PF3. Okay. Okay, but now let's see how these reactions, how the metals will react, correct, with these group elements. First, if we talk about magnesium, magnesium will react with nitrogen to form Mg3N2. Nitride ban sakta hai. Then lithium similar to magnesium, it will also form lithium nitride. Calcium forms calcium nitride also, and it forms calcium phosphide also. Got it? While sodium, if you talk about sodium, sodium will form only arsenate Na3S, correct? While zinc, if you talk about zinc, zinc will form antimony Sb3 and Zn3 Sb2. And if you talk bismuth, magnesium ka likha nahi, idhar hi likh deta hu. Magnesium also forms with bismuth Mg3 Bi2. These are few metals which will interact with these elements and make some metallic bonds here. Okay. So this you have to little memorize beta. Lithium, magnesium, calcium, sodium, zinc and magnesium. Okay. Magnesium bol diya maine. Lithium, calcium, magnesium, sodium and zinc. These are the elements which usually form some kind of metal bonds with these elements. Okay. Now, coming to the compounds. These are all the general properties. Now, coming to the compounds, nitrogen and, nitric acid and phosphorus compounds. Yahi hai groups mein. Let us see. Preparation of nitrogen. Okay. Ye thoda theoretical hai. So, we'll go a little fast here. Nitrogen is commercially prepared by liquefaction and distillation of air, because nitrogen pehle distillate ho jata hai at 77.2, pehle evaporate ho jata hai, then oxygen will come at 90 kelvins. Laboratory preparation, nitrogen is prepared by treating ammonium chloride with NaNO2. Okay, so ammonium chloride ko NaNO2 mein heat karoge, so you will get this as N2, okay, and NaCl is formed plus H2O. This is what you will get. Okay, a small amount of byproducts which are formed are NO and HNO3. Okay, ab ye NO aur HNO3 jo bhi form kar rahe na, usko hum log kya karenge? We will react this with K2Cr2O7 in acidic medium. K2Cr2O7 kya karega, kisi bhi form of nitrogen ko oxidize kar dega, and highest oxidation which it can raise is HCO3 and Cr plus 3. And this nitrogen gas, whatever NO gas which is present, that has got converted into HNO3. Jo bhi nitrogen gas tha, wo vaisa ka vaisa nikal jayega N2 ki tarah. Okay? So that N2 gas will come out. So basically, ye jo impurities hai, jo NO gas, jo ki nitrogen ke saath mix ho sakta hai, उसको हम लोग अवॉइड करने के लिए क्या किया, वी यूज K2Cr2O7 एंड कन्वर्टेड दैट NO इनटू HNO3 फॉर्म. क्लियर? सी, दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट, यू मस्ट हैव लर्नड इट एज ए GIC, जनरल इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री में आपने पढ़ा होगा कि हीट करने पर कैसे डिफरेंट डिफरेंट प्रोडक्ट्स आते हैं. ओके, सो हियर इन दिस टॉपिक अमोनियम सॉल्ट्स को हीट करना एक इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट है. लेट अस सी हाउ इट इज गोइंग टू. Ammonium salts of chromate, if you heat it, we will get this as N2 plus Cr2O3 plus H2O. And this becomes the important way of preparing nitrogen gas as well. Ammonium nitrite, if you see, it will give you N2 plus H2O. Okay. Now here, students, यहाँ पे हम लोग दो कैटेगरीज में बांट देते हैं, दैट अमोनियम सॉल्ट्स कैन बी आइदर ऑक्सीडाइजिंग, इट विल बी कंबाइंड विथ ऑक्सीडाइजिंग ग्रुप्स, ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एनायंस और नॉन ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एनायंस, नॉन ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एनायंस. ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एनायंस आर K2Cr2O7, ओके, NO2 माइनस, गॉट इट, NO3 माइनस, MnO4 माइनस, MnO2, MnO4 2 माइनस, गॉट इट, एंड ClO3 माइनस. ये सारे ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एनायंस है. ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एनायंस को अगर हम लोग हीट करते हैं, आई मीन अमोनियम सॉल्ट्स को, अमोनियम विथ दिस एनायंस इफ यू हीट इट, we will always get ammonium salts will always give us N2 gas. ये N2 देता है, एक exceptional case है NO3 minus N2O देता है, because उसके पास एक extra oxygen है, so it will give N2O, but otherwise they all will give N2. Non-oxidizing anions like sulfates, phosphates, okay, chlorate, perchlorate and chloride, bromide, all of this on heating, इसके salts सारे heat करेंगे तो ammonia देगा, because they are not acting like an oxidizing agent, so here only ammonia gas will come out of it, correct, on heating ammonium salts. Clear everybody? Is it making sense?
Yes, sir.
Coming to heating azides now. Azides are the best source for nitrogen, beta. It is been said that azides will give the purest form of nitrogen. So if we heat azides, okay, like barium azide, barium will immediately precipitate, nitrogen gas will come, and this, because there are no impurities in it, this is the purest form which you can get. Same is the sodium. Sodium get precipitated, nitrogen gas will come, and that will be the purest form. Okay. Next, urea with HNO2. Urea with HNO2 reaction is just like diazonium salt. Like we have C double bond O in H2. Diazonium salt kya karta hai beta? Primary amines ko alcohol form mein convert kar deta hai na. So same thing will happen here also. First it will form diazonium salt here, N2 plus. और यहां पर भी आ जाएगा N2 प्लस, और ऑन हाइड्रोलिसिस दोनों तरफ वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स आ जाएंगे, सो वी विल गेट दिस अ सी डबल बॉन्ड OH एंड OH एंड टू मोल्स ऑफ N2 गैस. क्लियर? सो आई होप दैट इज क्लियर एवरीबॉडी. राइट, नेक्स्ट, अमोनिया इन CuO एंड हीट, ये भी हम लोग काफी यूज करते हैं. फ्यू रिकॉल when we had to do benzene mechanism on benzene, correct? When we had to do benzene mechanism on benzene, we were using ammonium in the presence of CuO, okay? Because ye kya karta hai? Cu ko reduce kar deta hai. Right. So Cu will get reduced here, and on strong heating, it will become N2. Otherwise, initially it will form NH2 minus. Iske liye hum log usko base ki tarah use karte hai for benzene mechanism, plus H2O. This is what you will get. Now see the reactions. Nitrogen is relatively less reactive because of its very high bond dissociation energy, because it has a triple bond. Now, though N2, CO, N minus have the same bond order, correct? CO and CN minus are much more reactive because of their polar character, isn't it? CO and CN minus have a polar character and have an antibonding character of homo orbitals. So they will have an antibonding orbitals which can be reacted easily. हमने ये देखा है पहले as a ligands, right? In ligands you have seen that pi star orbitals होते हैं, carbon monoxide and cyanides, and they act like strong field ligands, correct? So that character is more developed in carbon monoxide and cyanides, and which is not there for nitrogen. Okay. Now let's see the reactions here. Lithium plus nitrogen, if you heat it, ये भी सारे हीटिंग रिएक्शंस आपने जीआईसी में पढ़ा होगा, सो जस्ट लेट अस रिवाइज इट नाउ. डायरेक्टली रिएक्शंस करने वाले क्या क्या रिएक्शंस है इसमें, ऑन हीटिंग डायरेक्टली जो कि नाइट्रोजन से रिएक्ट हो सकते हैं दैट इज लिथियम मैग्नीशियम विल ऑल्सो रिएक्ट डायरेक्टली नाइट्रोजन विल रिएक्ट विथ हाइड्रोजन डायरेक्टली टू फॉर्म अमोनिया विच वी कॉल इट एज द हेबर प्रोसेस एंड यू नो रिमेंबर आई कीप रिवाइजिंग दिस एवरी टाइम वी कम अक्रॉस दिस रिएक्शन इट इज एक्सोथर्मिक हेबर प्रोसेस इज ऑलवेज एक्सोथर्मिक नेक्स्ट boron will also react with nitrogen strongly to form boron nitride aluminium will form aluminium nitride if aluminium nitride is forming and carbon is been taken then aluminium nitride plus carbon monoxide will form okay next nitrogen and oxygen will only you know react with each other under either an electrical arc or a very extremely high temperature to form NO gas okay so I think these are all your GIC reactions so just recall it once okay finished everybody right now let's see what are the various other compounds of nitrogen ammonia is one of the compounds preparation see अमोनियम क्लोराइड को NaOH के साथ ट्रीट कर दो सो इट इज लाइक एन एसिड बेस्ड रिएक्शन ओनली बिकॉज अमोनियम हैज ए एसिडिक कैरेक्टर बॉन्ड सो इट विल इमीडिएटली गिव NH3 करेक्ट एंड NaCl प्लस H2O फॉर्म H2 ओके हीटिंग इज टू मेक श्योर दैट यू आर स्पीड अप द रिएक्शन एंड गिव मोर अमोनियम गैस आउटसाइड दैट्स इट सेम थिंग अमोनियम सल्फेट कैल्शियम हाइड्रोक्साइड सो दिस एंड We will see calcium sulfate forming here और calcium sulfate तो precipitate बन जाता है तो और भी easy होगा ammonia को निकालना next reduction of nitrites okay this is important from zinc's point of view zinc in basic medium ना बेटा वो अच्छा oxidizing agent है sorry reducing agent है so it will reduce any form of nitrogen into ammonia so it will give NH3 here also it will give NH3 here also Got it? Both the cases, and it will form Na2ZnO2, and here also it will form Na2ZnO2. The extra the extra oxygen will come out as O2 gas. That's it. Okay. Next, you see hydrolysis of nitride. Okay. So if you see Mg3N2, Al2N. Okay. On hydrolysis, nitrides will immediately form ammonia, NH3, and aluminium will form hydroxides and NH3. And even if you take HCl also, it will become MgCl2 plus NH3. अभी ये मैंने बताया already non-oxidizing anions के बारे में बताया, तो I'll just write it down here. These are all non-oxidizing anions, right? Chloride, sulfate, phosphate, ये सारे क्या करते हैं बेटा? They'll directly give ammonia. Plus HCl. Here, ammonia plus H2O plus SO3. And ammonia plus H2O, plus H2O plus P4O10. ये बन जाता है because phosphoric acid is a mixture of H2O and P4O10. Okay? यूरिया हाइड्रोलिसिस ऑफ यूरिया इससे पहले हमने HNO2 के साथ रिएक्ट किया अभी हाइड्रोलिसिस करो हाइड्रोलिसिस करोगे तो OH कार्बन के साथ चला जाएगा H अमोनिया के साथ नाइट्रोजन के साथ चला जाएगा यू विल गेट टू मोल्स ऑफ NH3 दैट इज द हाइड्रोलिसिस ऑफ अमोनिया नाउ दिस साइनामाइड रिएक्शन कैल्शियम साइनामाइड रिएक्शन ग्रुप 2 में भी आया है और इसको आप बार बार प्रैक्टिस करना क्योंकि दिस इज अ सीक्वेंस विच इज आस्क्ड मल्टीपल टाइम्स कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड प्लस कार्बन क्या बनता है बेटा कैल्शियम कार्बाइड बनता है एंड कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड बनता है अर्नो यू आस्क मी रिसेंटली राइट दैट एंड देन N2 इफ यू रिएक्ट इट विद N2 एंड हीट इट दिस विल बिकम कैल्शियम साइनामाइड दैट इज CaNCN प्लस ओके सम कार्बन विल बी लेफ्ट हियर सो ये दोनों का मिक्सचर को हम लोग कहते हैं नाइट्रोलिम So sometimes the mixture is asked, what is nitrolim? Nitrolim is calcium cyanamide plus carbon. Okay. Structurally, if you see calcium cyanamide, it is like this. Calcium 2 plus hai, और N2 minus with C triple bond N. अभी hydrolyze करोगे तो this will take away H plus, so I will get this as H2N and C triple bond N. And if you further hydrolyze, आपको ये पता है ना, cyanide on hydrolyze, hydrolyzation will become acids, so we'll get H2N COOH plus NH3, correct? So you can see one mole of ammonia has come from here. Next, if this acid is further hydrolyzed, correct? So if this acid is further hydrolyzed, ye ammonia bhi yahan se chala jayega as NH3 and we'll get CO2 plus NH3. And CO2 in the presence of calcium bicarbonate, I mean calcium hydroxide will become calcium carbonate precipitate and ammonia gas will come out of it. So that's how we can get ammonia gas in this entire process. एक बार अच्छे से देखना सब लोग, समझने की कोशिश करो.
Yes, sir.
Good. Next, see Haber's process. N2 plus 3H2 will give us 2NH3 and delta H is negative. It is exothermic. It should be enhanced at high pressure and high temperature. Well, it should not be very low temperature, although thermodynamically it is feasible, correct? Or itna bhi high temperature nahi hona chahiye that reaction will go in the backward direction. Okay. Now see the reagents. K2O plus Al2O3. That is used as the catalyst, okay, with Fe2O3 present. The old catalyst which has been used is iron as a catalyst and molybdenum as the promoter. We used to use iron as the catalyst and molybdenum as the promoter. Okay. One second. तो वंस अगेन थोड़ा सा स्टक हो गया. Let's see this properties of ammonia. Ammonia is a colorless, pungent smelling gas. It has hydrogen bonding in liquid state and solid state. It is highly soluble in water due to intermolecular hydrogen bonding. How does it react with oxygen? Okay. See, ammonia burns in oxygen, giving that yellow color flame. Okay. That yellow color flame is because of formation of nitrogen. Yes. So nitrogen, when it comes from ammonia, it burns yellow color. Okay. Next, ammonia with chlorine. All right. This depends upon whether you are using excess ammonia or excess chlorine. First, let us see excess ammonia here. If you add with excess ammonia, that is 8 moles of ammonia plus 3 moles of chlorine, that would give us N2 plus 6 moles of ammonium chloride. Okay. Let's see excess of ammonia. When you treat with chlorine, first you'll get N2 plus NH4Cl. And more excess of ammonia, if you treat with chlorine, it will give N2 plus some HCl also. And it is giving like 6 moles of HCl. Now these 6 moles will react with another 6 moles of ammonia. 6 moles of ammonia to get this as 6 moles of ammonium chloride. Got it? So this is the, if you take these two, then the overall reaction is, HCl will get cancelled. What is left with N2 and ammonium chloride is present. That's it. So you'll get this as N2 plus 6 moles of ammonium chloride. So this is with excess of ammonia. Okay. If you take excess of chlorine, what will happen? See, in case if you take excess of chlorine, 2 NH3 and 6 moles of chlorine. So So then I'll get 2 moles of NCl3, got it, plus 6 moles of HCl. Okay. So if you see the mechanism, like 2 moles of NH3 plus 3 moles of Cl3 will form N2 plus 6 moles of HCl. And this N2 plus Cl2 together will form NCl3. So we'll get 2 moles of NCl3. So overall reaction is 2 moles of NCl3 plus 6 moles of HCl. Here, everybody. How the reaction happens with bleaching powder? Ammonia. It's okay. How the reaction of ammonia happens with bleaching powder. Ammonia react with bleaching powder to release, to oxidize itself as N2, and this will become calcium chloride. That is, chlorine is getting reduced, becoming H2O. Next, how does it make a precipitation reaction? If you remember in salt analysis, we have taken ammonia in the reaction is always going to be ammonium hydroxide. And we took this with NH4Cl to make aluminium, chromium, and iron to precipitate. Right? This is from cation group 3. Next, HgCl2 and Hg2Cl2. Ye bhi humne confirmatory reaction mein use kiya hai. We have used this in the confirmatory reaction of mercury. Okay. So what we have used, ammonia, if you treat with HgCl2, it will form HgNH2Cl. NH2 ion as a minus and Cl ion as a minus connected with mercury. And with further ammonia, there is no reaction identified. While if Hg2Cl2 is present, that is plus 1 oxidation state, if you see, mercury will have Hg plus Hg NH2Cl. Now this would be black in color because of mercury, while this is actually white in color. So that is a differentiation we will see between Hg plus 2 and Hg2 plus Hg2 2 plus. Is that is clear? Now let's see. Moist ammonia. Suppose if we have moist ammonia, that should not be dried with few compounds, which are those H2SO4, we can't use it. Okay. We can't use P4O10 and we can't use calcium chloride. But we can definitely use calcium oxide. Aisa kyun beta? Kyunki ammonia is basic, na? Ammonia is basic, so it can react with H2SO4, P4O10, it can react with CaCl2. CaCl2 is also acidic, na? Salt hydrolysis, correct? HCl form karega strong acid. But calcium oxide is basic, isn't it? So this is basic in nature. So it is used for, correct? Basic in nature. So it is used for absorbing H2O from moist NH3. H2O from moist NH3. Clear? Ye JEE mein aa chuka hai, recently aa chuka hai. So learn karo why calcium oxide is to be used. ओके ये मैंने बता चुका हूं 1, 2, 3 केसेस में क्या होता है. एसिड बेस रिएक्शन विल टेक प्लेस हियर. ठीक है, आपको अगर प्रोडक्ट लिखना है, सो आई जस्ट राइट इट डाउन. अमोनियम सल्फेट बनेगा इधर, अमोनियम फॉस्फेट बनेगा, राइट, एंड हियर अमोनियम क्लोराइड बनेगा. हाइड्रोजन, वेल हाइड्रोजन इज नॉट देयर इन जेई सिलेबस, गॉट इट. So for now, I'm skipping it, but I have written it here, correct? So you can just go through it one. I'm just skipping this part.
Now, coming. Sir, it's not there even for advanced.
For advanced also, it is not there. But,
okay, sir.
It is not been coming questions from last 2010 onwards. There have been no questions here. Okay,
sir.
So keep it at the end. I've already written there. It is not there for advanced. Okay. Yes. Now see, oxo acids of nitrogen. What are the various oxo acids formed from nitrogen? Let's see. First one being hyponitrous acid. The minute we have plus one oxidation state, we say it is hypo, right? So you can see oxidation state of this nitrogen is plus one and plus one here. Okay. The hyponitrous acid can show two forms. It can show an anti-configuration, I mean anti or syn isomerization. Okay. Because both can be on cis and trans type one, right? Next. Nitrous acid. Nitrous acid is the case where nitrogen has plus three oxidation state. Okay. HNO2. Next, nitric acid. Nitric acid is when you have plus five oxidation state here. Okay. So this is the plus five oxidation state form which you has. Next. Pernitric acid. Nitric acid here, it is HNO4, where there is one peroxy linkage. Okay. HNO4, it has a peroxy linkage on it. These are the oxy forms. Now let us see. First H2N2O2. Okay, hyponitrous acid. It is stable, you know, at relatively low temperature. As you increase the temperature, it would immediately become H2O plus N2O. Okay. But ek cheez yaad rakhna, iska matlab ye nahi hai that reverse reaction is also possible. No, the reverse reaction is not feasible. Hence, we cannot say that N2O is an anhydrate of, you know, hyponitrous acid. N2O is a neutral oxide. This is a neutral oxide. So it is not acidic oxide. Although it is forming from this reaction, but it does not mean reverse is feasible. Clear, everybody? Right. While, if you take about N2O5, ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेटमेंट है दोनों के दोनों. इट इज द एनहाइड्रेट ऑफ HNO3. कैसे एनहाइड्रेट बनेगा? देखो, इफ आई टेक 2 मोल्स ऑफ N2O5, सॉरी, इफ आई टेक N2O5 एंड टेक 2 मोल्स ऑफ वाटर, देन वी कैन हैव HNO3 फॉर्मिंग ऑफ 2 मोल्स, सॉरी 2 मोल्स नहीं चाहिए देयर, सो 2 मोल्स ऑफ HNO3 इज फॉर्मिंग. व्हाइल NO2, if you look at it, NO2 को अगर हमने add किया water में, plus 2 moles of NO2, plus H2O, then it will form 1 mole of HNO2 and 1 mole of HNO3. मतलब, ये एक mixed anhydride है. It is a mixed anhydride of HNO2 and HNO3. These two are important statement. Which of them is mixed anhydride and not. Okay? Next. Nitrous acid, again, not for GE advanced. Got it? It is not there. But I'll give you a briefing here. Because ye iske questions kaise bhi frame kar sakte because it is used in organic. Okay? But directly, it hasn't been there in GE advanced yet. HNO2 is stable only in dilute solution. It can be prepared by acidification of barium nitrate. So you can see, for example, barium nitrate reacting with dilute H2SO4, barium sulfate will form as a precipitate, HNO2 will form. And we know that HN2O3, correct? N2O3 kya karega? H2O ke saath agar react karenge hum log, so directly HNO3 hi dega. Which means, N2O3 sirf aur sirf HNO3 de raha na beta. So in that case, I can say, it is the anhydride of HNO2. So this is an acidic anhydride of HNO2. Okay. So you got three oxides, everybody. One is NO2, N2O5 or N2O3. Aapko clear ho gaya hoga. N2O3 anhydride hai sirf HNO2 ka. N2O5 anhydride hai HNO3 ka. But NO2 jo beech mein hai, wo dono ka mixed anhydride hai. Yeah. Next. See the preparation. It is a weak acid. Right, HNO2 plus NaOH will give NaNO2 plus H2O, making an acid-base reaction. And HNO2 disproportionate even at the room temperature to HNO3 plus NO. Okay, and because the oxidation state is plus 3, it can act like both oxidizing agent as well as reducing agent. Okay, if it is acting like oxidizing agent, so basically what it does, यहां से वाटर एच प्लस को डाल दो और यहां से वाटर हटा दो, सो इट विल बिकम एनओ प्लस, एंड ये एनओ प्लस इलेक्ट्रॉन लेकर एनओ में कन्वर्ट हो जाएगा. ओके, सो इट इज स्लाइटली ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट बाय एक्सेप्टिंग दैट इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड बिकमिंग एनओ. ओके, सो वेयर डू वी सी दिस टाइप ऑफ रिएक्शंस? सी यहां पर मैंने लिखे है, देखो HNO सल्फाइड्स फॉर इंस्टेंस, S2 minus बहुत ही easily oxidize हो जाते हैं to get it as S and NO gases form. I minus will also get easily oxidized to get I2 and NO gases form. Fe plus 2 will become Fe plus 3 and NO gas. Cobalt plus 2 will become cobalt plus 3. SO2 will become H2SO4. SN plus 2 will become SN plus 4. These are all various oxidizing reactions, right, where NO is getting reduced and others are getting oxidized. HNO2 can easily be reduced, used as the reducing agent also, where others get easily reduced, like KMnO4, it will become Mn plus 2, and this plus 3 will become plus 5 oxidation state here. Okay, K2Cr2O7, same reaction. H2O2 in H plus is a good oxidizing agent. Chlorine is a good oxidizing agent, so it will react with HNO3 to give Cl minus here. Then beta. So it's not very difficult to understand HNO2. So check this reaction. Next. Let's talk about the last compound of nitrogen, which is nitric acid. Nitric acid is mainly prepared by two reactions. One is Birkeland-Ide, the other one is Ostwald's process. Let's see first one. Birkeland-Ide process is, you take N2 and O2 and fuse with electrical arc. So you will get NO. And this NO, if you further add excess of oxygen, it will react with it and convert into NO2. And NO2 को अब वाटर में ऐड कर दो, सो दिस विल बिकम HNO2 प्लस HNO3. वी जस्ट लर्न्ड इट दैट इट इज अ मिक्स्ड एनहाइड्राइड. एंड HNO2 इफ यू कीप इट फॉर लॉन्ग स्टैंडिंग, करेक्ट, देन इट विल आल्सो कन्वर्ट इनटू HNO3 प्लस NO. अच्छा, जो भी NO आएगा उसको रिसाइकिल कर दो, सो अगेन NO इज रिसाइकल्ड. ओके, इन द सेकेंड रिएक्शन इट इज रिसाइकल्ड. So that's how we will start preparing more of HNO3. Here, everybody. So see the steps. First, nitrogen is oxidized with O2, then to form NO, and then NO is converted into NO2, and NO2 dissolves in water to give HNO3 and NO, and NO is further recycled. That's it. Here, everybody. See Ostwald's process. Ostwald's process, we take ammonia as a starting material. Ammonia react with O2 in the presence of platinum gauge. Okay, platinum gauge here. And what we do, we on reacting with this, we'll get nitrous oxide, nitric oxide, and H2. Same process again, you'll get NO2 here. NO2 will get HNO2 plus HNO3 here. And further process, you know that HNO2. On long standing or in water, it will become HNO3 plus NO, and NO is recycled. That's it. Now, one thing you must observe, that aqueous HNO3, correct, on distillation produce an azeotropic mixture which is 68% HNO3 by mass. Okay, so yahan pe separation karna difficult ho jayega. Once you have 68% mass of HNO3. Okay. So HNO3 is further concentrated by treating it with concentrated H2SO4, which is a dehydrating agent. So ye azeotropic mixture aane ke baad, we use H2SO4 to remove out that water content to further, you know, make it more concentrated. Okay. And this way it gives 98% HNO3. Okay. That's why it is being used. Next. See the properties of HNO3. See, pure HNO3 is colorless liquid, but on long standing, it will become yellowish due to its decomposition in light. Okay. HNO3 in the presence of light will start becoming NO2 plus H2O. Got it? NO2 plus H2O. Plus O2 also there, no? Half O2. Okay? Half hai, nahi. Full O2. O2, yeah. Right. So we will see that NO2, H2O and O2 are being released here. And this solution would appear yellow. Okay. Next, HNO3 also acts like an oxidizing agent, right? In different conditions. First, dilute condition. Dekho beta, ye aapko percentage wise thoda sa information yaad hoga to better hai, but at least you should know that there are three conditions of HNO3. One is dilute, sorry, very dilute, which is 6%. One is dilute, which is around 20%. And one is concentrated, which is minimum 60%. Minimum 60% should be present. So as the concentration increases, right, its oxidizing power increases. That's why you will see, agar high concentrated hai, toh almost sabko oxidize kar deta hai. So you can see reactions with metals. Concentrated HNO3, if you take, concentrated HNO3 will oxidize, you know, metals into higher oxidation states. यहाँ पे रिएक्शन कैसे हो रहा है? इमेजिन दिस, HNO3 इज बिकमिंग H2O प्लस NO2, ओके, एंड गिविंग नेसेंट ऑक्सीजन, एंड दिस नेसेंट ऑक्सीजन विल रिएक्ट विद द मेटल्स टू फॉर्म सम मेटल ऑक्साइड्स, करेक्ट? और आई कैन राइट दिस एज M2OX, ओके, सो दिस मेटल ऑक्साइड्स विद HNO3 विल बिकम MNO3X, क्लियर? Plus H2O. This is the overall reaction which is happening. So you can see that ye nascent oxygen ko agar humne hata diya, ye metal oxide ko hata diya, the final products are water, NO2 and nitrous, you know, salts, nitric salts. Okay. So metal plus HNO3 will become metal nitrate plus H2O plus NO2. So this is the result. Yeah. Now look at this, mercury with concentrated HNO3. So what would it form beta? In this we can practice easily, plus NO2 plus H2O. The same goes for all of them. Okay, silver mein likh deta hu, baki aap complete kar dena. NO3 twice plus NO2 plus H2O. Sorry, not twice, only once, right? NO3 plus NO2 plus H2. Now this is all about metals. Now metals which have metalloids which will act or which will react with concentrated HNO3, like tin, arsenic, antimony, they have more metalloid property. So this will become acidic. H2SNO3 plus NO2 plus H2O. The same goes for rest. So H3AsO4 plus NO2 plus H2O. Antimony is also just like, you know, arsenic. So antimony O4 plus NO2 plus H2O. Instead of salt, it will form something like acids. Next. This is a very important statement. Beryllium, aluminium, chromium, iron, cobalt and nickel. They all will become passive with concentrated HNO3 due to formation of thin oxide layer. हम लोग बीच बीच में कभी ना कहीं आते रहेगा. So you just check it out. What are all the elements you should look out for? Beryllium, aluminium, chromium, iron, cobalt, and nickel. These are passive with concentrated HNO3. Noble metals. If you see, this is also a case which could be asked. That how the reactions happen in aqua regia. So gold, platinum, rhodium and iridium, which are known as noble metals, when you react with concentrated HNO3, they only dissolve in aqua regia. They directly do not react with concentrated HNO3, but if you keep it at aqua regia. So to remind you, what is aqua regia? If I take HNO3 and HCl in the quantity of 1:3, that is aqua regia, and in this solution these noble metals will get dissolved. Okay, So due to less oxidation of gold platinum, they will form a complex with concentrated HCl. Hence, oxidation of silver and platinum is favorable in this forward direction. Like HNO3 plus HCl, kya banega? It will form NOCl plus H2O plus Cl2. Okay, so HNO3 is first oxidizing that HCl to Cl2, and whatever the gold which is formed here, that with HNO3 and HCl will form a complex HAU, okay, Cl4 plus NO gas coming out plus H2O. The same logic applies to platinum also. So where we have HPT Cl6 plus NO plus H2O. Got it? This is how it is formed. Now you can see aqua regia appears to be yellow color due to the formation of NOCl. It appears yellow color due to formation of NOCl. Now this is all about concentrated HNO3. Now if you have dilute HNO3, what will happen? Reaction with metals, dilute metals, if you take it out, then it will produce metal nitrate. It will definitely produce metal nitrate. But if the metal is above hydrogen, then N2O is produced. Instead of NO, it will produce N2O. Okay. There is two exceptional things. That is, lead gives NO and tin gives ammonium nitrate. Let me show you what are all the reactions. For example, zinc, iron, lead, tin, correct? Ye sare ke sare kidhar aate hai beta? Ye hydrogen ke niche aate hai na? So because of that, you'll see zinc become NO3 twice, plus it will oxidize to give N2O. I mean, nitrogen gets reduced to become N2O and H2O. Iron, same thing. Fe, NO3 twice, plus N2O plus H2O. Lead, we just learned that lead is the exception of giving NO plus H2O. Well, I should have written it down, okay? But its ka electrode potential negative hai. Okay. Next, tin plus dilute HNO3 will give SN NO3 twice plus ammonium nitrate. This is what is formed. But if it is above hydrogen, correct, then NO gas is liberated in all of these cases, like copper, silver, mercury, sare upar hota na electrode potential. So they will become cuprous nitrate, silver nitrate, mercuric nitrate, and releasing NO gas in all of them plus H2O. This is with dilute HNO3. Next, very dilute HNO3. If it is very dilute HNO3, how the reactions will take? All of them I have added it once here. So if it is treated with aluminium, you'll get aluminium nitrate plus ammonium nitrate. If it is with iron, iron nitrate plus ammonium nitrate. Zinc, zinc nitrate plus ammonium nitrate. Okay. If it is with manganese and magnesium, correct, unke electrode potentials are very, very less compared to hydrogen. So then MnNO3 twice is formed with H2 gas getting released. Right. Similarly, MgNO3 twice is formed with H2 gas getting released in this case. Clear? This is the cases with concentrated and dilute HNO3. Now look at it. Organically, reactions which you must know is that if I take toluene and take concentrated HNO3, you will get 2,4,6, 2,4,6 nitro groups here. So here, here, and here, we'll get all nitro groups. Right? This is how it is formed. Okay. If it is with concentrated HNO3 for phenols, we know that it will oxidize to give quinones. This is the major product. Right? Although, baki bhi hote hai, that we will have some part of, 2,4,6 groups here. but the major product will be oxidized form. This is how it is formed. Okay. Next, if you have only, you know, cyclohexanol, this will become quinone. The secondary alcohols will become ketones. And this on further reaction with concentrated HNO3, okay, agar isko further reaction kar rahe ho, to ye bond toot bhi jata hai, ye sirf cyclic case mein hota hai. Ye toot bhi jayega, aur dono taraf COH aa jayega. COH 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and COH. This is known as adipic acid. With cellulose, you know, we will get cellulose nitrate. So it will become cellulose nitrate. Not that structure is important. You just need to know it is just cellulose nitrate form. Okay.
Sir.
Haan, beta.
Sir, I have to leave now because I have to go out somewhere.
Yeah. It's okay.
Sir, can you please send the recording on WhatsApp? After
we'll take by night data, mostly tomorrow I'll
okay. Recording. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. See how the reaction happens with non-metals. Okay. Specifically, iodine. बहुत बार पूछा है जेई में. So iodine पे ध्यान देना. बाकी क्या है ना general reactions है. Like carbon becomes carbon dioxide, which is highest oxidation state. Phosphorus become P4O10, which is also highest oxidation state. Okay. और क्योंकि ये वाटर में रहेगा, इफ इट इज इन वाटर यू कैन राइट इट एज H3PO4 आल्सो, ओके, एंड सल्फर में रहेगा, सल्फर होगा तो H2SO4 होगा, बाकी सब क्या होगा, NO2 गैस, NO2, ओके, बट इफ इट इज विथ आयोडीन, राइट, इट इज नॉट गोइंग मैक्सिमम ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट, इट इज गोइंग ओनली अप टू HIO3 plus NO2 plus H2O. Apparently, HIO3 is more stable than HIO4. It would try to exist more in the iodic acid form only. Okay. इसके लिए इसको ज़्यादा पूछा जाता है कि you know student get confused that HIO4 बन रहा है या HIO3 बन रहा है. Okay. Right. See, oxidation of compounds. If you take dilute or concentrated solutions, correct, in either of the nitrous acid, S2 minus and all of these, ye pehle humne likha hua, same compound se jo likha hai, wo kis mein oxidize hote hai beta? Sulfur, I2, Fe plus 3, SN plus 4, converts to carbon dioxide, converts to sulfate, SO4 2 minus. Okay? These are the cases you will get. Agar ye acidic medium mein hai, in H plus, then you can write it as H2SO4. Next, see what are the oxides of nitrogen. Nitrous oxide, see there are five oxides here. Isme aapne NCERT mein dekha to sirf ek table hai, sare reactions nahi hai, sirf ek table diya hai. So table mein kya kya points hai uspe emphasis karunga, otherwise reactions main samne likhte jaunga. Okay, look at it. Nitrous acid is about N2O, it is dinitrogen monoxide. The preparation wise, if you look at it, it is, you know, ammonium nitrate. मैंने बताया था इसको heat करने पर N2O आता है instead of N2. And zinc in dilute HNO3, we just learned that it will give N2O and zinc will become ZnNO3 twice plus H2O. Okay. Hydroxylamine, NH2OH, hydroxylamine in the case of NaNO2 will also give you N2O plus HCl. NaCl plus H2O. This is the information given in NCERT. Got it? So that N2O is neutral, colorless, diamagnetic gas, and this is its structure. You have to structurally pata hona chahiye. N triple bond N with O, and you can make it as double bond N, double bond O this way, or this is another structure. Clear? Next, see nitric oxide. What is nitric oxide? Nitric oxide, it can be prepared by, we just learned it, that copper plus dilute HNO3 will release NO. Ostwald's process में NO आ रहा है, Birkeland process में भी NO गैस आ रहा है, so that's how we can prepare NO. A nitric oxide can be purified by passing the mixture of acid through FeSO4, okay, which we call it as brown ring test. हमने already किया हुआ है. So if we take NO, that can be purified by passing through FeSO4. The brown ring is formed, which is unstable on heating and shaking. It will again releases NO. जो भी impurities है, निकल जाएगा. So we'll have NO. NO is paramagnetic because it has an unpaired electron. It is neutral and it is colorless as well. So you can see, you can write this as the Lewis structure. You can show in this format also. And nitrogen or oxygen ke beech mein bond order is 2.5. Bond order is 2.5. Okay. Clear? This is also mentioned. If you take, you know, it will form a loose dimer. Okay, it will form a loose dimer like this. N with O and another bonding with O here and N here and this form at low temperature. So just remember, it forms a loose dimer at low temperature. Next. Nitrogen, sesquioxide means 2:3 ratio. So whenever there is a 2:3 ratio, we call it as sesquioxide. Nitrogen trioxide, it is formed when you take NO, treat with N2O4, which will give us N2O3. Okay, sorry, N2O3. N2O3 would be a blue color solid form. Okay. It is acidic in nature. So I think I told you already that this is the anhydrate of HNO2. So if you add it to water, it will become HNO2. Structurally, you know, in JEE, more structural questions have been asked here. So you can see N2O3 structure looks like this, where you have NN bond here. Okay. अच्छा, ये NN bond के बीच में भी oxygen आ सकता है और ऐसा bond भी exist करता है. Correct. But if you see the stability wise, यहाँ पर ज़्यादा bonds है. So 2, 4, 5, 6. While here we have 6 bonds, but apparently here we have, where is it? यहाँ पे आपको resonance करने को मिल रहा है इधर से इधर end तक. So which resonance is not possible on this end. So this would have more stable form. So this is more stable form. But this form can also exist. Okay. This was one correction came in JEE Advance once, that there was a question asked like, which of the following, you know, have NN bond, correct? NN bond किसमें exist करता है और कुछ compounds दिए हुए थे जिसमें से first key में N2O3 नहीं दिया था. Now later on the key was changed that both NN bond can exist as well as NON bond can exist here. Both bonds can exist. So learn it. NN and NON both exist here. Next. Nitrogen dioxide. Nitrogen dioxide, NO2. We learned it on heating. We'll get NO2. Or if you take concentrated HNO3, then also we'll get, you know, NO2. Or in Ostwald's process, we have looked at NO plus O2 will give you NO2. NO2 also has one unpaired electron all the time, so which makes it also paramagnetic. Okay. And because of this unpaired electron, it would attain a reddish color, reddish brown color gas. Reddish brown color gas. Okay. And because of the unpaired electron, it shows paramagnetic property. Okay. Now, see beta, whenever there is an unpaired electron and it is non-delocalized, agar wo kahin delocalized nahi hota hai, then it will undergo dimerization. Non-delocalized electron undergoes dimerization. And that's why you will observe NO2, correct? 2 moles will dimerize to form N2O4. And N2O4, now if you look at, once it forms N2O4, now it will become colorless because there is no unpaired electron. It becomes diamagnetic. Becomes diamagnetic, and it can exist in both liquid as well as solid state, unlike a gas earlier. Okay. So structure wise, this is N2O4. So I think now you know questions kaise puche the. N or N bonds kitne nitrogen oxide mein hote hai. So here you can check that this has only NN bond, no NON bond here. Okay. There's only NN bond. Okay. Next, C. Liquid N2O4 is used as non-aqueous solvent and can be used to prepare anhydrous metal nitrate. So when you do not want to use water, then we can use this, because N2O4 in liquid form can become NO plus and NO3 minus. Okay. So zinc chloride, if you add it to the pure N2O4 solvent, then it will become zinc nitrate, NO3 twice. And NO plus will take away that Cl to become NOCl. You use the same logic here. Ye aage jaake aapko group 17 mein help karega, same reactions. NO2 plus F2 will become, aap aise hi socho, NO3 minus hoga yahan par, NO2F ban jayega ye. So it is because of an unpaired electron it has. So this unpaired electron will pair up with one fluorine here, and like I said, 2 moles. Same thing would happen with chlorine, 2 moles of NO2Cl. Okay. And here also NO2F aa jayega, correct? And xenon will get reduced, 2 moles of this. NO plus Cl2. If you take directly NO plus Cl2, agar hum log NO2 nahi lete, to directly we'll get it as NOF, NOCl, and here we will get this as 2 moles of NOF, and xenon will get reduced. Correct. Yeah. These are few reactions. And lastly, nitrogen pentoxide. See nitrogen pentoxide, how the reactions. Nitrogen pentoxide, if you take HNO3 and treat with strong dehydrating agent like P4O10, then it will dehydrate to N2O5. Correct. And this will become HPO3. Okay. HPO3 is also known as metaphosphoric acid. Metaphosphoric acid. So N2O5 is prepared this way. Okay. Achha, metaphosphoric acid kabhi kabhi aap confuse ho jate ho. Basically, metaphosphoric acid kuch nahi hai. H3PO4 hai. H3PO4 ban raha hai. And because if you may have, in fact, more amount of P4O10, that will again squeeze out water out of it. So, agar isme se water fir se hata do, to kya banega? HPO3. That's how metaphosphoric acid. So, metaphosphoric acid or H3PO4 mein difference nahi hai. Just the water which you have removed out. That's it. Okay. Next. See, structurally how N2O5 is. N2O5 will have NON bond only, not NN bond. It will have only NON bond. And it exists in this form, and it will be existed as a gas, N2O5 gas. If you solidify at low temperature, then it will exist as a solid as NO2 plus and NO3 minus. This is the solid form which it exists. Okay. Anyways, N2O5 otherwise is, you know, there are no unpaired electrons, so it is diamagnetic. ये इंफॉर्मेशन है ना कि वो सॉलिड में होगा कि डायमैग्नेटिक है स्ट्रक्चर कैसा होगा ओनली दैट टेबल इज गिवन इन एनसीईआरटी सो जेई मींस इफ यू चेक आउट ओनली दैट टेबल इज सफिशिएंट इनफ ओके सो इट इज डायमैग्नेटिक देयर आर नो अनपेयर्ड इलेक्ट्रॉन सो इट इज कलरलेस गैस एज वेल ठीक है ओनली वन रिएक्शन विच इज बीन यू नो यूज फॉर N2O5 डायरेक्टली इज रिएक्शन विद सोडियम Sodium will undergo oxidation to form NaNO3, and that one mole will get reduced to get NO2 gas. That's it. Okay. This is about nitrogen and its family. I mean, nitrogen and its compounds. Next, this group is slightly bigger, beta. So if you see phosphorus, in phosphorus, mainly you need to learn about its allotropes and acids. That's it. Mainly allotropes and acids. See, allotrope wise, there are white, red, black, scarlet. These are the allotropes, phosphorus allotropes. First, white phosphorus. White phosphorus is a strained molecule because you can see white phosphorus has P4 structure. In P4 structure, this is sp3 hybridized. If it is sp3 hybridized, we expect that to be 109 degrees. But here, how much is the angle? 60 degrees. So it is highly strained molecule. Okay. It is insoluble in water because from four directions, there is no dipole moment appearing. So it is insoluble in water, but it is soluble in CS2. Okay. It readily catches fire, correct, because of its highly strained molecule. And delta H formation of P4 white, we have already assigned it as zero. Remember in thermodynamics, we have taken that delta H formation is zero. It readily catches fire and then it is stored in, you know, H2O, because in H2O it is insoluble, correct? So we can store in that. Next. It is highly poisonous. It glows in dark. And when it glows in dark, we call the names as phosphorescence and chemiluminescence. This is about white phosphorus. See red phosphorus. If you take white phosphorus, heat it strongly in an inert atmosphere for many days, then it will convert into red phosphorus. Red phosphorus is slightly polymeric. It would have a polymeric units, correct? So structure wise, if you look at it, it is like P, okay? Connected with another P here, P and P. Bas ye dono mein bond hai. Ab ye dono mein bond nahi raha. Ulta, wo bond idhar shift ho chuka hai. Again, P, 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 P and P. And this keeps continuing on both the sides. So if you guys understood that, you can see this is how it will get continued. Okay. Now here, if you look at it, this phosphorus has sp3 hybridization. All of them will have sp3 hybridized orbitals. So this is a polymeric phosphorus, which is what we use it on the math sticks. That is the red phosphorus form. This is less reactive than white phosphorus. It does not catch fire with O2 on heating. It is insoluble in water and CS2. It is non-poisonous. It does not glow in dark. Okay. Coming to black phosphorus. This is the most thermodynamically stable form. Because ye red phosphorus ko bhi bahut zyada heat karne par, that too in the inert atmosphere, then it will become black phosphorus. So black also has alpha kind and beta kind. So it is alpha black phosphorus. And if white phosphorus is directly heated at high pressure, that will give beta black phosphorus. Beta black phosphorus. Okay. And if white phosphorus heated very strongly, it can convert into P2 gas also. P2 type of a gas, which is highly unstable with a bond order 3, which means P triple bond P jaise. Okay. It is also diamagnetic, just like nitrogen, but unstable form, unstable at low temperature. So the low pressure. If you bring it to low pressure, it will again immediately become white phosphorus red phosphorus. Okay. So this is the difference between white, red and black phosphorus. Okay. Now see what are the components of phosphorus. Phosphorus, the first component is PH3, phosphine. How is the preparation? See, phosphides can be prepared straight away by hydrolysis, just like for nitrides we have done. So we same thing will happen here. Calcium chloride will form here in this case. And other form is PH3. So PH3 will form this. Same reduction of PCl3 with lithium aluminium hydride will also give you PH3. Heating of phosphorus acid. I told you that it will undergo disproportionation. So gives +5 oxidation state and -3 oxidation state. So that's how we will get phosphine. White phosphorus with alkali. This also I told you disproportionation. P4 plus NaOH will give you NH3 plus NaH2 PO2. So pure phosphine is non-inflammable, but if impurities of P4 or P2H5 are present, that are present, then it will become inflammable. Okay. See, P2H4 burns in air and forms a vortex rings. Okay. So P2H4, if you combine it with PH3, okay, and expose it to air, it will start, you know, forming a vertex kind of rings, correct? And this vortex ring is what we use in identification of ships. So where, you know, ships are lost. So normally what they will do, they will use this phosphine gas and we treat it with P2H4 so that vortexes are formed in the air. The pure phosphine can be obtained by treating the gaseous mixture with anhydrite, you know, HI, and then reacting with alkali. Okay. If you see PH3, for example, if you take PH3 plus P4, right, plus P2H4, all of this, you know, impurities which are present in the presence of anhydrous HI. First, it will form PH4 plus and I minus. We discussed this reaction before also. And once you treat that with KOH, and this will become PH3 plus KI and H2O. So that's how we can prepare PH3 as well. Okay?
Yes.
Right. See the properties. Phosphine. Okay. Is a colorless gas and with rotten fish odor. It is stable in air but ignites on heating to 150 degrees. Okay. So it will ignite at around 150 degrees. And on photochemical decomposition, it produces red phosphorus. It reacts with copper sulfate and HgCl2 to give Cu3P2, that is phosphide, with copper and mercury. Okay. Remember this, that when I said that decomposes, produces the red phosphorus, what I meant is PH3, correct? If you expose it to light, then it will become red phosphorus and H2 gas will come out of it. So that's how it gets decomposed. Clear? Next, see what are the chlorides of phosphorus. Although chlorides, direct reactions are not there in NCRT. Okay. You just need to know, one thing, only one preparation is given. So just check it out. PCl3, P4 plus Cl2 dry with a limited amount, it will give PCl3. If you add excess, it will become PCl5. That's it. Okay. And see the second reaction. P4 plus SOCl2, if you react, this will become PCl3. Okay. And sulfur will become SO2. And S2Cl2. Right? So this is one way of preparing PCl3. Okay. Next, hydrolysis. PCl3 on hydrolysis, you know, will give you H3PO3, because H3PO3 is the acid for the same oxidation state plus 3HCl. If you add it with heat here, this H3PO3 will, remember, it will undergo disproportionation. So it will undergo disproportionation to give H3PO4 plus PH3 plus HCl. Okay. That's how the hydrolysis take place. Now, PCl3 usually is used in organic reactions. Like for example, if you take alcohols or acids, so what do we get? We'll get 3 moles of alkyl chloride, alkyl halide, and H3PO3. And same is the case here also, 3 moles of RCOCl plus H3PO3. Okay. It oxidizes POCl3 with O2 and SO3. Okay. Which means if you take PCl3 plus SO3, it will become POCl3, correct, plus SO2. Basically, think this way, PCl3 plus O2 is becoming 2 moles of POCl3. Okay, so whatever extra oxygens will have, that will become POCl3 only. Next, see PCl5. Phosphorus plus chlorine, if you add excess, it will become PCl5. Earlier, if you recall, I used SOCl2, right? SO2Cl2. There, we were getting PCl3. Here, we will get PCl5 and you know, SO2. So I hope you understood the difference. Earlier here, I took, you know, SOCl2. While here, I'm taking it as SO2Cl2. So that will convert into PCl5. It will oxidize further. That's it. Okay. Next one, hydrolysis. See what is happening on hydrolysis. PCl5 plus water, correct? It will become, all the chlorines will try to come out of it and we'll get this as POCl3. Correct? Because once you have two OH groups, it will undergo double bond formation here. So this POCl3, you know, which is forming plus HCl. Achha, I have written minus HCl there already. Let me write here also. Plus HCl. Now, this POCl3 plus H2O, further adding on to H2O here, right? So that finally becomes H3PO4 and 3 moles of HCl. Got it? This is about the hydrolysis. Next. PCl5 reacts with molecules having OH. All of these are organic reactions. So I'll just go brush it up once. See, alcohol plus PCl5, you know that alkyl halide, POCl3 plus HCl. Acids will become ROCl plus POCl3 plus HCl. Sulfuric acid will also become SO2Cl2. Nitric acid will become NO2Cl. And boric acid will become BCl3 plus POCl3 plus HCl. All of them are, you know, same type of reactions. Everything will become POCl3. Next. You see, PCl5 is reacted with organic or inorganic molecules with nucleophilic oxygen. Then it gives POCl3. For example, SO2, SO3, P4O10. They have this oxidizing property. So, phosphorus will take away that O and becomes POCl3. Okay. And if it is sulfur, it will take away the chlorines and will become SOCl2. Correct? Okay. So this is how it is getting reacted. So it's like exchange reactions only. One oxygen is exchanged here. Two chlorines are exchanged on this side. Okay. Same way, if you treat it with POCl, SO3, it will become POCl3. And this will become SO2Cl2. Okay. If you react with P4O10, then you'll get 10 moles of P4Cl3. So idea is simple. Jahan par bhi PCl5 dikhe, wahan pe product hamesha POCl3 aa jayega. Okay. Got it. Only two molecules, see, carbon dioxide and O2. Inka bond dissociation energy P double bond O से ज़्यादा होता है. P double bond O, if you compare with C double bond O or O double bond O, correct? Then C double bond O will be stronger than O double bond O, then P double bond O. That's why if you have CO2 or O2, they do not give this reaction with POCl3. Otherwise, rest all of them will give this reaction. Now, come to this. PCl5, structurally, you know that it is trigonal bipyramidal. So we have Cl, Cl here, Cl, Cl and Cl. Structurally, bipyramidal. This, on heating, we would get this as PCl3 plus Cl2. Right? Now, we also know the fact that this bond is much weaker. These bonds are much weaker compared to that of these bonds. Right? That is, axial bonds are weaker than the equatorial bonds. So, PCl of axial bonds are weaker than PCl of equatorial bonds. All right. Now, that makes it to form something like, so in solid form, it can form PCl4 plus and PCl6 minus. Bromine also, if it can form PBr4 plus and Br minus, correct? Not PBr6 minus. Remember this carefully. यहाँ पर सिर्फ Br minus बनता है, but here it will become PCl6 minus. So see the difference there. Okay. Now look at it. PCl5 oxidizes finely in the finely divided metals, you know, into chlorides. So that is basically क्या कर रहे हो आप? Heat कर रहे हो तो PCl3 और Cl2 बन रहे हैं. That Cl2 is the reason why it is undergoing oxidation. So silver will oxidize in chlorine. they give AgCl. So on heating, you see the overreaction, we are getting AgCl plus PCl3. And same happens with tin also. Tin will give SnCl4 and phosphorus will become PCl3. Here, everybody?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt here? One second.
No, sir.
Yeah, one second.
What is this NAPGC achievers thing?
What, beta?
So, what is NAPGC achievers?
What is the
achievers match? Kya hota hai, sir? Usme add kya
hai? I didn't get it. What?
Sir, PS mein achievers match kya hota hai?
No idea, beta. They made it this time.
वहाँ से कोई NAPGC achievers 2022 करके ग्रुप में ऐड किया इधर कोई और है क्या उस ग्रुप
में? I don't know. Nobody has told me anything.
So like just few hours ago they added us.
Oh. I'll check with others. Okay.
And sir, is this crash course thing for everyone या फिर separate course से उन लोगों के लिए जो 12th के बाद चालू करने की कोशिश कर?
See, oxides of phosphorus. There are two main oxides. One is P4O6, the other one is P4O10. आपको क्या पता होना चाहिए यहाँ पे? Mainly is the structure. So P4 white. If you treat with limited oxygen, you'll get P4O6. Now, P4O6, if you look at it, it is all sp2 sp3 hybridization on both phosphorus and oxygen. So structurally it looks like this. Aapko pop bonds banane hain. Dekho kitne pop bonds ban rahe hain. Ek idhar, do, teen, char, panch and che. So 6 pop bonds are being made. So you can think like this. Pehle hum log ek chair form banayenge aise, fir chair ke upar aise ek do extension dal denge. Correct? Teen extension dal denge phosphorus ke upar. So that's how you can get this, you know, P4O6 formation. P4O6 on hydrolysis will give you phosphoric acid, phosphorus acid. And if you heat it, you'll know that it will undergo disproportionation. Next one is pentaoxide, P4O10. On excess amount of oxygen, we'll get P4O10. Structurally, same chair form jo humne likha hai, waise hi likhna hai. Except that the phosphorus will also have double bond O. डबल बॉन्ड ओ एंड डबल बॉन्ड ओ जो कि हमने यहाँ पर नहीं लिखा था. यहाँ पे कोई भी डबल बॉन्ड ओ नहीं लिखा था. तो यहीं पर अगर आपने यहाँ पे डबल बॉन्ड ओ एक डबल बॉन्ड ओ एंड डबल बॉन्ड ओ यहाँ पर आप डाल दोगे सो दैट वुड बिकम फॉस्फरस पेंटाऑक्साइड. क्लियर? दैट्स ऑल यू नीड टू फिगर आउट हाउ इट इज टू बी डन. ओके, फॉस्फरस पेंटाऑक्साइड इज द एनहाइड्रेट फॉर H3PO4. दैट इज इफ यू एड इट वॉटर H3PO4 विल जनरेट. Okay. Now, this you might have done in GIC, that how dehydration is to be done. P4O10 is one of the strongest dehydrating forms. If you dehydrate acetic acid, you'll get acetic anhydride, CH3COO and CO, single oxygen. No? Yeah. O this way, plus, you know, HPO3. HNO3 will become N2O5 plus HPO3, H2SO4SO3 plus HPO3. Okay, amides will become cyanides, CH3 C triple bond N plus HPO3. Okay, chlorates Cl2O7 plus HPO3. This is how it will happen. Okay. Now, less common oxides which are formed here is this. Suppose, yahi structure mein, imagine I remove one oxygen from here, or two oxygens from here, or three oxygens from here, or four oxygens from here. If you remove all four, it is P4O6. If you add one oxygen, P4O7, two, P4O8, P4O9, and so on. So these are, you know, few other, you know, common oxides which we can be observed. So in case if you hydrolyze that, you'll get this as H3PO4. This will be 2 moles of H3PO4. This will be 3 moles of H3PO4. Got it? and rest of them will be, you know, 3 moles of H3PO3, 2 moles of H3PO3, and 1 mole of H3PO3. So remember it this way. So 1, 2, 3 here and 1, 2, 3 here. Okay. Clear, everybody?
Yes, sir.
That's it. Now, next is only the oxo acids of phosphorus. Oxo acids is pretty simple here. Phosphorus acids, correct? Phosphorus acid, if, you know, we will go towards plus one oxidation state, then that is hypophosphorus acid. Agar usme se do molecule ko leke water hata denge, so this will become pyrophosphorus acid. Phosphoric acid can become metaphosphoric acid and pyrophosphoric acid, which if you remove one more oxygen, you'll get hypophosphoric acid. All of them, I put it like a table here. So that is one thing. I'll explain it in the next session. Right. So that's the last part of it.